Hi friends, welcome to Taming Python series. In this video, we're going to talk about how to connect to an Oracle database using SQL Developer and DBWer. SQL Developer and DBWer are database administration tools which provide a great GUI to connect to the database and control stuff like creating tables, editing rows, inserting rows, deleting rows, and etc. So you don't need to know more coding or SQL to control your database, which makes it very easy for administering the database. So the first tool we are going to know about is SQL Developer. And SQL Developer is a database administration tool created by Oracle, and it is free. You can download the SQL Developer tool as a zip folder from here. I'll give the link of this in the description. So here in this page, you can see SQL Developer 21.4.1 download. So basically, it's the SQL Developer download page. And here, since I'm using Windows 64-bit computer, I will download this Windows 64-bit with JDK 8 included. So if I just click on this download button, you have to click OK. And then you'll be prompted to the login screen if you're not logged in. And then you'll be given this zip file. Since I was already logged in with an Oracle account, I have got this zip file download screen directly. If you don't have an account in oracle.com, you can create a free account and then you are able to download this SQL Developer zip file. So click OK and then zip file will be downloaded. Here I have downloaded my Oracle SQL Developer tool zip file, and after extracting the zip file, I got this folder something like this. And inside the folder, there is this folder called SQL Developer, and inside the SQL Developer folder, there is an exe file called sqldeveloper.exe. So basically, you need to search for sqldeveloper.exe file, and if I just double click this exe file, SQL Developer will open. So this is like a portable software where you don't need to do additional installation. You just double click the exe file and you will get the SQL Developer tool. And after opening the SQL Developer, you can see there are no existing connections in this SQL Developer. So I need to create a new connection to my database. In our previous video, we have created an Oracle database using Oracle Express Edition, which is a free Oracle database for development and testing. So if you don't know how to install Oracle Express Edition, check out my video. I'll leave the link of that video in the description also, so that you can see how to install Oracle Express Edition. Alright, so let's try to create a connection here. I'll just right click and create new connection. So here you can see this is a new connection form. So you need to fill some parameters to connect to the database, right? So since my database is running in my own computer, I can see the parameters of my database to connect. So I'll just open the command prompt here. I'll just click CMD and open my command prompt. And I'll write a command called listener control space status. So the spelling is LSNR listener control CTL space status. So this is the command, listener control space status, and if you click enter, you can see this is the Oracle connection information, and here you can see my Oracle port is 1521 and I need to connect to a pluggable database. So XCPDB1 is the pluggable database, so it's the service name which I have to connect to get a pluggable database of the Express Edition. So I just go to my SQL Developer and here write the connection name. You can write any connection name, so I'll just write local connection, and then username I'm going to connect with the sys user, so I'll write sys. And since I'm connecting with the sys user, I have to write the role as sysdba. If you connect with any other user like system or any other usernames which you create, you can connect with the role default. But since I'm connecting with the username sys, which is created by default while installing the Oracle Express Edition, and I'm writing the password which I've created while creating the Oracle database, and I'm saving the password for further use. And since Oracle is installed in my own computer, I'm writing localhost. Since the name of the pluggable database is XCPDB1, I'm writing XCPDB1 in the service name field. And here also in the command prompt, we have seen that the port is 1521. So I'm leaving the port as 1521. So let me try to test my parameters. Here you can see I got status success. That means I have written the connection parameters correctly. So I'll just finish this new connection by clicking the connect button. And here you can see my local connection is created. So if you expand this local connection, you can see there are tables in this database. And since I'm using the sys user, I'm seeing the sys schema. I'm seeing the tables inside the sys schema. These are all the default tables present in the sys schema, which are required for Oracle to run. So these are created when the database is created. And I don't want to insert my tables in this sys schema because it's confusing to mix up with default tables. So I need to create a new schema. So creating a new schema is really simple. Just scroll down and click on this other users. So you can see all other schemas present in this Oracle database. These are also default schemas. I did not create any schema till now. So if I just right click on this other user and create user, you'll get a new user creation form. And here you can write the new username, which is the name of the new schema. I'll just write the schema name as test1. And I'll write a password for that. And here I will give some roles called connect, DBA, and resource. So connect for connecting, DBA to control the database, and resource. And now here you can see the SQL is created here. So basically, I'm creating a user test one, identify the password, which in my case the password was pass, and I'm granting three rows to this user, and I'll click apply. And here you can see my SQL is processed successfully. And now here you can see there is a user called test one in this database. So if I just expand this and see the tables of this user, currently no tables are present. If I want to create a new table in this test schema, I just right click on this, create a new table, and here name of the table. So I'll just write the name of the table as test underscore table. I want to create a new ID column. So this is the ID column, it is a primary key, and I want to make this ID column as an integer. So I'll make this as integer. I don't want to make it null, so I'll mark it as not null. And if you want to auto increment this ID column, you just click on this identity column and select the type as generated as identity and generated by default not null. That means if you don't provide the ID column, it will be generated by default as a serial number. So I have successfully created the ID column. So if you want to create a new column, suppose say name. So I'll just write name and type. I want to keep it a varchar 2 and I want to store name still a limit of 500 characters and I want to be not null. And the default value, you can set the default value. In my case, I want to set the default value like NA, not applicable. So this is my database table definition. So if I just click OK, you can see I've got a new table called test table created and these are the columns. And here you can see ID is a number with auto increment feature. And here in the data tab, if I click on the data tab here, I can see no table rows because I've created the table just now. So if I just click on this plus button, which is insert row, I can create a new row. So if I just write name something like ABCD and just commit using this commit changes button, you can see I've created a new row. If you want to edit this, click on this, do something like XYZ and click OK. And commit the changes, you can change the database rows. If you want to delete this row, just right click on this and you can delete the row, delete the selected rows and commit the changes. So this way, without writing any SQL, you can manage table data or create tables or delete tables using SQL Developer. So SQL Developer is a really powerful tool if you want to administer your database very easily without any SQL. And you can obviously write SQL code in this database. You can just right click on this database connection, right click and open SQL worksheet. And here you can execute your SQL like selecting database columns, deleting database rows, dropping tables, whatever you want. So this is a very quick overview and how to use SQL Developer. All right, we have successfully completed how to use SQL Developer to connect to an Oracle database. Now let's move on to another tool, which is called DBWare. So DBWare is a free universal database management tool that supports many databases along with Oracle. You can download DBWare for free from here. So let's open this link, dbware.io/download. Community edition is free. So click on the Windows 64-bit installer and click next, 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 and you'll get DBWare installed in your computer. I've already installed DBWare in my computer. And if you want a detailed user guide of DBWare, I've already created a video on how to use DBWare. So you can check out that video to know more about DBWare. I will leave the link of that video in the description. So please be sure to check it out. So let's open DBWare now. I've already installed DBWare. I'll write DBWare. And here, this is my app DBWare. I'll just open this. And here you can see already I have two databases, Postgres and SQLite selected. So I want to create a new Oracle database here. So let's right click on this new database button and here I will select Oracle because my database is local Oracle database. So I'll double click this and here I have to fill the Oracle connection parameters. So just like SQL Developer, my host is localhost because the Oracle database is running in my own machine. If your Oracle database is running somewhere else, you have to write the IP address or host name. And the port was 1521 and the database service name was xcpdb1 and the username was sys and I have to connect with the role as sysdba. If you enter other username other than sys, you can select the role as normal, but since I am using the sys username, I am selecting the role as sysdba and I'll write the password that I have created while creating the Oracle database. And that's it. Let's try to test the connection. And here you can see I got my Oracle database connected. So I'll click OK and finish so that I can see a new connection here in this connections tab. And if I just expand this, you can see the schemas. And here inside the schema, you can see different users. You can see the test one user, which you have created in the SQL Developer. If you just expand this, you can see the tables here. Here you can see the test table, which you have created in the previous SQL Developer demo. And here you can see the column definitions. And if I click on the data, you can see the data. Currently, there is no data. If you want to create a new row, just right click, edit, insert new row. And then you can write the name here. And you have to save using this save button. And that's it. Refresh this. You can see the auto incremented ID also generated here. And you can edit the name also something like this and then save it. So that's how you can use DBWare to connect and control your Oracle database. You can see I have created a blog post on connecting to Oracle database using SQL Developer and DBWare. I have also given you some useful snapshots on how to connect to your database, and I have also given you the links to download the tools. I have also given you the references so that you can do further reading. So be sure to check out the link of this blog post in the description of this video. Hope you like this video, guys. Thank you for watching.